Hi there, this is Elizabeth Smith from Roundtree's studio, and this is my desk. I wanted to take the time to show you a little bit about working with vellum, and I thought you would find it interesting to see more of the overall work area before I zoom in on the vellum itself. This is a piece of vellum. It's processed calfskin. In this case, it's been finished on one side. This front side is very smooth to the touch. It's noticeably smoother than watercolor paper. The back side has a sort of suede-y finish to it. I would not be inclined to paint on, but I haven't tried. It's also possible to get vellum which has been processed on both sides. That's called manuscript vellum, and it's used for things like book pages. Vellum is far more translucent than your typical watercolor paper. This is 140-pound Arches watercolor paper, and this is the vellum held over the same image. I put down some quinacridone red on this piece of vellum and the same pigment on this piece of watercolor paper because I want to show you the primary difference I found between working on the two different surfaces. If I were to take a brush loaded only with water and drag it across the vellum, it lifts paint very easily. It does vary from vellum piece to vellum piece. Some are more porous than others. And of course, if I want to make this neat, I could have made this very neat and lift quite a lot of that. I'm not doing the neatest job, but you get the idea. It comes up very easily. I'm not applying a whole lot of pressure. If I try to do the same thing on the watercolor paper, I have to work a lot harder. Still not coming up. Not much. I'm still working on it. I'm gonna try to dab that. So the point here is that the pigment doesn't stick much to the vellum. It sits on the surface, and although some pieces of vellum are more porous than others, and the pigments stick more than others, in general, it's easy to fix mistakes, and it's also easy to inadvertently lift paint on layers beneath the layer you're working on. This means that you have to work very gently and very patiently, or you lift under layers and have to start all over again. And that's kind of frustrating, and certainly takes some getting used to, but you're still able to build up color very nicely if you take the time to be patient with it. This is the painting I started on at Carol Woodin's workshop this last weekend. I'm working on an irregularly shaped piece of vellum because it was cut from near the edge of an animal skin. If you purchase your vellum in full skins, then naturally they're going to be animal shaped rather than rectangular, so you have to plan the best use of the square footage you can and expect to have some scraps. I have left a fair amount of space around the painting itself. The working area there is about 3.5 by 6 inches. And I've left a lot of room because the vellum responds more to climate and humidity than paper does. If you're used to working with paper, then the vellum could surprise you, and you need to take that into consideration when you do any framing.